In an effort to make people more aware of cyber attacks, Worcester has begun training all employees on what to look for and what to avoid. The city says attacks on municipalities have become more prevalent, and they want to make sure they are one step ahead. Our Chandler Walsh has the details.
All it takes is one click on a bad link, and an entire city's information could be taken by hackers.
It's like an epidemic out there, and it's happening on a daily basis to cities and towns.
The city of Worcester is increasing cybersecurity efforts, training all 1,600 employees.
The weakest link is the employee. So they're the ones that are going to receive those fake emails. They're the ones that are going to be tricked into clicking on a link or providing the information because they think it's from a known source.
Suzanne Zargis is Worcester's cybersecurity training specialist. She'll finish the first round of training by the end of the month.
So they can see firsthand a number of red flags that they should be looking for in every email that comes through.
Zargis says hackers could steal data from one or more department, anything from archives to email to electronic records, and hold it for ransom.
Think of everything we use on a daily basis that is connected to the internet or involves technology and not having access to that.
Attacks cost victims millions of dollars, resources, and time. Chief Information Officer Eileen Kazaropol says the city has had to shut down the internet to fight against viruses and says several fake emails go to city employees each month.
We'll send it out from the help desk to all the users, letting them know that this is the latest, fake email that's circulating the city.
Cyber criminals also target hospitals, schools, and corporations. Kazaropol says the criminals are resourceful, so they want to stay one step ahead.
They're doing their homework. They're looking at what departments have sensitive, confidential, financial information, and they're targeting those departments.
Kazaropol says the FBI frowns on paying ransom, but some municipalities or groups have no other choice. Sargis says cybercrime is now more profitable than the global trade of all illegal drugs combined. Chandler Walsh, Worcester News Tonight.